Okay, Monica C., how do we know when we have guidance or if our spirit, our angels are with you? Well, it's kind of, this is kind of in alignment with what we were just saying. It really does begin kind of with a boring answer. So I'm going to apologize right away because I know people want to hear there's flashes of light and auras and stuff. And that does happen, but it usually starts with becoming more observant in all ways, becoming more observant in all ways. For example, just a piece of this for people who want to tune into and expand their clairaudience, which is the ability to hear in the world of spirit. The best way to do that is to go outside, sit on a park bench and listen and identify every single stream of sound. There's the birds, there's the kids playing soccer, there's the couple walking by in their conversation, there's the rustling of the leaves and the trees. All these different streams of sound and separating them out and tuning into them and then pulling back, zooming out a little bit and perceiving it as one beautiful stream of sound, but noticing it. Why? Because in noticing what is normative in your life, what's normal, what ought to be there, it becomes very striking when something enters in that's non-normative. When suddenly you hear a sound that sounds like music. How many of you guys actually can hear music sometimes when you're in your bed at night and all the lights are off, the TV's off, and kids are asleep? You can hear something that sounds like tones or frequencies. And if you lean into it without chasing it, because then that repels it, it kind of can turn into chords and singing and music, and that's clairaudience. But if you don't know to listen, if you don't know to pay attention, you'll not know that that's not normative. So spiritual evidences come in a way that can feel familiar, but they're not necessarily normal to your regular experience. Now, guidance, when it comes through, especially in the beginning, and for those of you on with me last night, I did talk about this last night as well, but when spirit communication is coming through in the beginning, when you're first starting to get really interested in building your own inner wisdom and hearing what spirit has to say, it often comes in through the faculty of your own voice. Now, if you want to know what your own voice sounds like in your head, pick up a book and read a paragraph to yourself. Don't read it out loud, read it in your mind. That's your inner voice. And so when spirit first starts talking to you, it kind of sounds like that, but with a little bit more heft, like a weight to it. And if you wanted to interpret that emotionally, it'd be a little bit more purpose to it, a little bit more meaning to it. So just a little heavier energetically, not in a bad way, like a dense way, but just a little more meaty, if you will, than your normal thinking thoughts. Actually, your normal thinking thoughts are quite ambient, usually, most of them. You're driving in your car and you're thinking about, what am I going to get for dinner tonight? I wonder what my husband's doing or what are we going to do tonight? These are just floating around ambiently. They don't feel anchored to something yet. When spirit speaks, it's very purposeful. It's not ambient and floaty. It's right there in your awareness. And if you actually try to locate it physically, it feels like it's right there in the center of your head because it is coming through the pineal gland, which is the third eye. And it exists as a physical gland right in your head, which is what I call spirit's microphone. Is this thing on? I just did this last night. But it can seem like it's originating right in the center of your head, and anything telepathically transmitted also feels that way. It's like this booming resonance that comes in the center of your head. So in the beginning, it does come in your own voice. So it's easy, therefore, to dismiss it and say, oh, that's just me. That's just my imagination. Pay attention to the heft of it. Pay attention to the meaning of it. It's like the difference between a regular dream, all crazy, all nuts. What does that mean? And a spiritual dream. We've all probably had a spiritual dream and they feel different, don't they? There's more meaning to it. You wake up thinking, I wonder what that was about, but you want to look into it. That's the difference in heft I'm talking about, or the difference in meatiness, if you will, between a spirit communication and an actual thought that you're thinking yourself.